in sum number 23. A spring is kept compressed by a small trolley of mass 0.5 kg lying on a smooth horizontal surface. The significance of this smooth horizontal surface is that you have to ignore friction. Okay? Anyways, in your sums, all the sums which you have in syllabus, you are not going to get sums involving frictional force. When the trolley is released, it is found to move at speed V equal to 2 meter per second. What potential energy did the spring possess when compressed? Now, when the spring was compressed by the trolley, it was possessing the potential energy due to which type of potential energy? The gravitational potential energy. The elastic potential energy, that is the potential energy which a body possesses due to the configuration. Okay. Now when we release the trolley, what will happen? The spring will try to come back to its original position. As a result, the potential energy will be converted to kinetic energy with which the trolley will move. Otherwise, we are not supplying any energy to the trolley, right, from outside. So, the potential energy possessed by the spring when compressed is equal to the half mv square. That is the kinetic energy the trolley will possess when it will move, right? So, we have just substituted the values mass 0.5 kg, velocity 2 meter per second, simple calculation, 1 joule is the answer. Now, look at sum number 9. A block A weighing 100 Newton is pulled up a slope of length 5 meter by means of constant force 100 Newton. What is the work done? First part. What is the work done by the force in moving the block A 5 meter along the slope? That means work done to move this block along the slope. So see, the direction of force is also given. Force acting in the same direction in which the body is moving. So simple work done will be force into displacement. Force given 100 Newton, displacement 5 meter, because we are just pulling up the block along the slope by a distance of 5 meter. So 500 joule. Now the next part is, what is the increase in potential energy of the block? Increase in potential energy, obviously there will be an increase, because initially when at ground, height 0, so potential energy 0 joule. When we move up the block, what is the potential energy? Mg is already given. What is Mg? Mg is the weight. If I multiply G with mass, we will get the weight. So this is already given, 100 Newton. So 100 into 3, because this is the height at which the block is now placed. So 300 joule. Now increase in potential energy, simple, 300 minus 0, 300 joules. Okay, look at this sum, chapter 2c. A stone of mass 500 gram is thrown vertically upwards with a velocity 15 meter per second. Calculate the potential energy at the greatest height and kinetic energy on reaching the ground. That means you're throwing the stone upwards. It will reach a certain height, after which it will automatically fall down. So at that certain maximum height, you have to find the potential energy, and when it will again fall down, you will have to find the kinetic energy when the stone will reach the ground. For the first part, potential energy at the greatest height. So if this is h, it's not given to you in the sum. If this is h at greatest height, remember we have done in the conservation of energy principle, when we were showing a stone is dropped from certain height, that at different stages, what are the energies it will possess? So at maximum height, first of all, when we are throwing the stone upwards, it is possessing some kinetic energy. Obviously, we are throwing the ball or stone. In this case, it is stone. we are throwing the stone with some velocity, so it will possess some kinetic energy. What is the kinetic energy? Half mv square. We have got velocity, we have got mass. Simple calculation, just substituting the values. Now then, how will I find the potential energy? When it will reach the maximum height, whole of the kinetic energy will get converted to potential energy, because at maximum height velocity will be zero. So kinetic energy zero and potential energy will be 56.25 joule, because energy is not destroyed. So where will the energy go then? It will get converted to potential energy. Now when the stone automatically falls down, when it reaches the ground, H will become zero. If H is equal to zero, potential energy is zero. That means the whole of the potential energy, which was the whole of the potential energy, means potential energy at the greatest height. Because otherwise, when the stone is falling down, gradually potential energy is getting converted to kinetic energy slowly, potential energy decreasing, kinetic energy increasing. On the ground, potential energy minimum, that is zero, kinetic energy maximum. Reverse happens when we go up, that means when the stone is thrown upwards. So kinetic energy on reaching the ground, 56.25 joules again. Now the third part, total energy at its halfway point. Remember, we have done this also. At any instant of this path, what will happen? The total energy will remain constant, mgh. What is mgh in this case? You can either use the kinetic energy or the potential energy simply. Potential, when the stone is falling down, what is the maximum energy? That means the total energy, mgh. So this mgh is, you don't need to substitute any values. You can straight away put the value of the potential energy. Because if at this point, if potential energy is 56.25 joule and kinetic energy is zero, at some other point, potential energy will be some value and kinetic energy will also have some value. But whatever be the value, at all instants of time, total energy will be constant. And what is the constant value? It cannot exceed this value. This is the maximum, this is the total energy. Sometimes potential energy being minimum and sometimes kinetic energy being minimum. So this is the, according to the conservation of energy principle, we can say that total energy is 56.25 joule at any point when the stone is falling down. Okay, now let's look at sum number 4. In this case, it is said that a skier weighing 60 kgf stands at A. Okay, one more thing. Weighing 60 kgf means the weight is not 60 kgf. The mass is 60 kg. Weight is, you have to multiply this to make it in Newton. So mass is specified here, okay? So this is basically the gravitational unit of force, you know that. A skier weighing 60 kgf stands at A at top of the sky jump. So from here, he makes a jump and lands at B. Calculate the change in gravitational potential energy of the skier between A and B. So if we have to calculate the change, so we need to calculate, first of all, in short I've written GPE, this is actually gravitational potential energy, okay? You better note it as gravitational potential energy. Okay, so in order to calculate the change, let's first calculate the gravitational potential energy at A. How do we calculate? Mgh, mass 60, 10 given, g is 10, into 75, because the height is 75, h is 75. Again, gravitational potential energy at B, same mgh, h is 15. Now You can either calculate the result here and just subtract, or you can also do it in this way: change in gravitational potential energy 16 to 10 into 75 minus 16 to 10 into 15 joule. We are just taking 16 to 10 common. See, in both the cases we have 16 to 10, so just taking out 16 to 10, we are left with 75 minus 15. If you find this difficult, no problem, you can simply just calculate the value and subtract this minus this, A minus B, 60. So we are getting the result as 36,000 joule. Now the second part: if 75% of the energy in part A, not this A, part A, that means the change in gravitational potential energy which we calculated, this value, 75% energy, 75 by 100 of this value we have just calculated, if this becomes kinetic energy at B, kinetic energy at B means half mv square. What is m? M is given again 60. What is v? Which we have to calculate. Speed at which the sphere arrives at B. So we are just substituting the value and calculate v squared. V squared equal to 75 by 100 into 36000 by 60. Obviously it will come in the denominator and 2 will go in the numerator when they are changing the sides. So v square is this, so v will obviously will be equal to root over of, just do the calculation on your own, you will get 900 and v will be equal to 30 meter per second. Okay, so this is the sum. Okay, just I want to say that when you are writing the units, I have found in your exams that many of you tend to make a mistake with the symbols, or say you are writing ampere as this one, or say kg as like this. This is wrong. We have already covered the convention of writing the units and their symbols. Maybe I have not taught you, but your previous teacher has taught you how to write. There are some guidelines for writing the units. When we are writing, we have used in this chapter several times kilowatt hour. So it's not that K capital, W capital, okay? This is small. This prefix will be small letter. Also, only the units which are in the name of the scientists, those will have the initials, that means the first letter in capital letter. For example, say watt, or say for example Newton, but not meter. This is wrong. And you tend to use these forms which are wrong. And also, if you are writing Newton in full, say in not in short form, not in symbol, if you are writing in full, then it will be Newton, not, then it won't be capital. If you are using the short form, then only capital. Say kilowatt hour or watt hour, whatever you are using. So don't use this prefix for kilometer, anything. Don't use this as capital letter. And please be careful about the way you are writing the units. And the regarding the remaining sums, go through the sums once the school reopens. If you face any difficulty in doing the other sums, we will discuss it at that time. And we'll resume with our lessons in the further sessions. Okay.